Hey there, Shannon Ward with ColorWorks. I'm so excited to be here with you today, and I'm taking over Toddler Tuesday just for today. Caitlin's a little under the weather, and I'm gonna do Toddler Tuesday today, and we're gonna talk about the ugly gray boxes. Again, I'm Shannon Ward. I'm the founder of ColorWorks and the author of Parenting by Personality, so let's get started, okay? The ugly gray boxes are really cool to understand, but not so much fun to see yourself in. There's a link below to get this free handout today about the ugly gray boxes. So you can go ahead and print it out now if you're near your computer, or if you're watching this in some other form, you know, go back to it later, but we'd love to have you have this free handout of the ugly gray boxes. What I want to talk to you today about, first of all, is what are they? And some examples of them. Second of all, why do we use the ugly gray boxes? And third, some antidotes. So first of all, what are the ugly gray boxes? Well, basically they are 8 different categories of command and control tactics that we as parents will use, especially when we are frustrated. And so these are kind of like some stress behaviors that can come out in us, especially dealing with children who are misbehaving. So it really can happen a lot, and it starts when our children are toddlers, okay? Now there's 8 different categories, but only 3 of them really are used for toddlers. The other ones we start finding ourselves using when our children start getting a little older than toddler age. But the 2 that we seem to find a lot in parents of toddlers, and that I used when I had toddlers myself, is the general, the mover and the shaker, and the movie critic. So the general tends to be parents who are first or second color golds, and they tend to be the general in times of stress. And the tactics that they use are often orders with threats and commanding language, okay? So some of the things that they might say is things like, stop crying right now or I'll give you something to cry about. So the stop crying is the command, or I'll give you something to cry about is the threat, okay? They might say something like, why are you always losing your shoes? Go get your shoes, just go find them. So the question is, why are you always losing your shoes? Implying that there's a place for them, they're out of place, they didn't take care of them, they didn't do what they should have done. And so just go get them, just go do it. So the command and the frustration is there for the gold parent, okay? Gold parents will use the general sort of tactics of command and control language when they are under stress because they are finding that things are getting out of control. Things are out of order or not where they should be, or they're going to lose track of time or their schedule is gonna get off. And so those frustration moments for a gold or second color gold parent can be huge. And that's when the command and control language can come out especially. The mover and the shaker. The mover and the shaker tends to be the first or second color orange parents. And they're not so much worried about the schedule or keeping things under control. They're worried about hurrying up. They're worried about getting things done in a hurry and being more efficient in their time, okay? And they will use a strict commands, give lots of how-tos, and they usually have a time frame on it. They're the ones that are gonna go, get your shoes now, okay? Hurry up and get in the van now. Move it, come on. Those are things that the orange mover or shaker parent will say. And they're just trying to hurry things along so that they can get on to the next thing, to the next thing, to the next thing. So eventually they can either relax or get to the fun or just have the day be over, okay? The third one is the movie critic. And this doesn't happen a lot, but it can. And the movie critic is very much about kind of showing their superiority, okay? And you know, all the colors can do this at different times in different ways and for different reasons, but they're more interested in kind of letting the child know that, hey, me adult, you child, okay? And can be kind of condescending, and they tend to use ridicule, some blame, some sarcasm. You know, they would be the ones that are like, really, you're gonna cry now? Oh my gosh. Or they could be the ones that, you are such a baby. Or they would be the ones that are saying things like, oh yeah, there's my toddler. And there's some ridicule and some criticism kind of mixed in with that. Or something like, really? Cry? Okay, I'll give you something to cry about. Okay, that kind of thing. So the movie critic can be used. They tend to be ones that can be a little more sarcastic, have a little bit of snarky behavior. But it's not effective either, okay? So between the general, the movie critic, and the mover and the shaker, those are the three that oftentimes kind of is used on toddlers, most often than not. So kind of talked a little bit about what the ugly gray boxes are. It's those categories of command and control tactics that parents use under stress or out of habit that, you know, seems like it'll work in the moment, but it's not really effective in the long run. Which brings me to more of why we do it. So why do we use the ugly gray boxes? Well, one of them is because of habit. We kind of get into this way of acting and talking and being that we think is going to be effective and get what we want. And we keep using it over and over again, even if we're getting results that are not what we really want. Another reason could be that that's all we know. It could be that we do command and control language because that was what was used on us as children, or that's what we see. And so command and control behavior can come from that. And another thing, a reason why we do it is because we are genuinely so frustrated that we're kind of in automatic mode, and now we're saying things and doing things without really thinking about them, and it comes out with periods on the end. Command and control. Hurry up. Stop that. Cut it out. Do this. Find your shoes. So that can come out almost automatically. But here's something interesting about the ugly gray boxes and why it's so important to understand which ugly gray boxes you might use and why it doesn't work is because what the ugly gray boxes do in our children is over time, there's only two outcomes that we get from continual use of the ugly gray boxes. We may use them in the moment because it seems like it's working, but in the long run, it's very ineffective parenting. And the reason why is because either we will end up with very rebellious children who push back, fight us, and there's constant conflict, or we get children who knuckle under, who are passive, who will do anything that we want out of fear. And we are creating fearful children. Either one of those outcomes is not effective, and it doesn't help our children be strong and be value-driven and make good choices. The rebellious ones are always looking for some way to get around the rules and to do something that gives them freedom or lets them be themselves. Where the passive ones, they just want peace and they will do anything to not get in trouble. And that's not good either. It's because what happens is think about if that carries into their teenage years. We're gonna have teenagers, if they're rebellious, that will do things, even if they sometimes think through what the risks are, they will do the things just because they can. And the passive ones, the ones who knuckle under, the ones who are fearful, they won't stand up for themselves in situations where they really need to. They won't know who they are, and so they can follow any type of leader that they'll find. And there are plenty of other teenage leaders that would love to have a group of minions following them. So it all stems from using command and control language with our children when they're young. And so when we're using command and control language on our toddlers, that's when we are forming habits as parents and we are teaching our children, even as young as toddler age, what to expect from us. So what are some of the antidotes? Okay, so I've shared with you what the ugly gray boxes are, the command and control tactics, and why we use them. And some of the outcomes of using them are not where we want to be. We're trying to be effective parents and efficient in the moment, but all we're ending up doing is creating either very rebellious children or children who are so passive they won't stand up for themselves when it's the right time to. So what's the antidote? Okay, well, the antidote, first of all, is to use more choices. To put a question mark with kind of a dot, 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 but put a question mark at the end instead of putting a period on the command and control, okay? So the first thing is to understand that choices get you better results, okay? And so instead of saying, hurry up and get in the van, you can say something like, so you have a choice. You can either hurry up and get in the van or I will pick you up and carry you. What do you want, okay? You could say if they've lost their shoes. I'm using all toddler examples right now, okay? Let's say that they can't find their shoes. So you could say, so you have a choice. You can't find your sneakers and that's upsetting you. So you have a choice. You can either put on these little flip-flops and we need to hurry up and go, or you can let mommy pick you up and we'll just get you in the car seat because we have to go pick up your brother, okay? So that's, then you're giving them choices. Let's see, what's another example off the top of my head? One that we had to give to our grandson who's three this weekend was one where he really wanted milk and his mom wanted him to have water. So I said, you can have a choice. You can either have your water in this blue cup or you can have it in a yellow cup. And it distracted him from wanting the milk. And so he took water in the blue cup. So anytime that you can give them control over something, my shoes example wasn't very good, but the water in the blue cup or the yellow cup, that's a really good example. Anytime that you can have them focus more on what they can control, that's a really good thing to do. We had a mother one time who had a toddler that wanted their milk in a certain place on the counter so that they could pick it up. And it was driving this mom crazy because if she even moved it to another part of the kitchen, this little toddler would just get really upset. So, but she would always say command and control things like, no, there it is, you can have, you have to take it from there or don't have it at all. And, but it was really command and control. It wasn't put in the form of a choice. And so what we shared with her and suggested is put it in the form of a choice. So here's your hot chocolate. You can either take it from this corner or you can take it from the table, which do you decide? And so even though they wanted it from the corner of the counter, because it's a choice, they were more likely to take it from the counter and not have it be a big deal. Another thing you can do with the choices is that you can have the choice be either the choice of the thing that you really want them to do or the consequence of not having it. For example, with the milk on the corner of the counter, it could be something like, you have a choice. You can either take your milk from this counter, from the corner of the counter, or not have your milk at all. You decide. Or you can say, what's your decision? So when you give toddlers that choice back, they tend to really kind of go with it. Now you might have a meltdown or two at the beginning, but follow it through and let them know that you mean business. And if you will do these choices with your toddler and follow through, let them be upset without the choice, go take them to timeout. We have videos on timeout or begging or things like that. But let them know that you mean business. And then on the next day or maybe 2 days later, pretty quick, they will understand that, oh, I better take my milk from the corner of the counter than fighting about it because I really want my milk, okay? So first of all, an antidote is to give your child more of a form of a choice. Instead of do a command and control with a period on the end of it, start using choices. Now, when it comes to choices, let me give you some more information. Sometimes choices are between the thing that you really want them to do and the consequence if they don't, and that's okay. That's an okay choice. In fact, that's a really good choice for a green or for an orange because you have put them on notice that they can either choose the thing that's going to give them freedom or make them seem smart, or they can choose the consequence, which is going to teach them that they're not going to have the freedom or the thing that they wanted. Another thing about choices is sometimes choices are between two good things, but it's not the choice that they want, okay? So let's say that they want to play Play-Doh right now, but you're not at a place where Play-Doh is something that they can do. So instead you can say, I understand you really want to play the Play-Doh, but that's not a choice right now. Instead, you can color or you can play with these puzzles. What do you want to do? And most often, toddlers are going to choose one of those other things. If they try to argue with you, again, they're being rebellious or they're pushing back very early because you've probably been doing lots of command and control stuff, just insist on the choices and say, no, I'm sorry, these are your choices. You can color or you can play with the puzzles. You decide, or you can have timeout, which is it that you want. And usually when you have the choice of the timeout or that they have to go to their room or that none of the choices will be given, they will pick one or two of the other things that are better choices for them. Another antidote is to really understand how to use the Ask, Be, Do parenting system that we teach in our ColorWorks Basic course. And that goes much more into depth as how to change behavior with a couple of different skills. Now, sometimes one of the things to do is to really listen to your child and even a toddler, because they can explain a lot sometimes, those older toddlers who are pretty good with their words and their language. There's a lot that you can do that is more of a listening skill to understand what they're upset about. And also we can help them learn to change behavior, especially for an orange, by learning how to really use rewards, okay? Those are other videos, or maybe come join our class and we can share more things with you. But the biggest antidote for command and control language is, after you catch yourself doing it, is to change the wording into some sort of choice, okay? And I hope that helps. The ugly gray boxes are the kind of thing that are gonna keep you awake at night, because that's when you're thinking, wow, why couldn't I have been calmer longer? Why couldn't I have been kinder? Anyway, the ugly gray boxes, understanding them is one of the things that helped me be a better parent, because I realized that's not the kind of parent I wanted to be. And that's kind of what started me on my journey of creating all of this, you know, 17, 18 years ago, was understanding the command and control tactics of the ugly gray boxes. So hope I've given you some information with your toddlers. Caitlin will be back next week. Remember to get your freebie in as a download. Click on the link below. And Caitlin will see you next Tuesday. Come see me on Question and Answer Thursday. I'll have some cool stuff I'm going to talk about on Thursday. And goodbye for now. Thanks.